Hello! Today I'm going to unbox the knit crate and the sock crate for October. So today I'm going to unbox the October knit crate and sock crate. So today let's go ahead and unbox the knit crate first. Just a heads up that the knit crate did come in an envelope mailer this month, and that's only because the new magazine that they've come out with was just a little bit too heavy and it put them over their 1 pound limit. So they just put them in mailers this month, but next month they're going to divide up the magazines to where they don't weigh as much and they'll be able to go back to their boxes. That's what the email that the knit crate people have sent me. So let's go ahead and open up the knit crate and let's see what colors I got. Wow, I got the color I wanted. Ooh, it's so pretty. This is Aldine Wools. It is the colorway Mouse. It is 50% alpaca, 30% merino wool, and 20% nylon. It's a DK weight. It has 236 yards or 215 meters, and that's 100 grams. All Aldine Wools yarns are made exclusively for Knit Crate. And you get two, and they're absolutely gorgeous. I love these grays. There is some dark grays and some light grays in it. It's really beautiful, and it is so soft and so pretty. I actually looked on the Knit Crate website to see what the four colorways were available this month, and this was actually the one that I really, really wanted. So that's really cool and really neat. And I'll put on the screen the other four colorways for you. And you can see what else you could have gotten in the knit crate this month. Now let's see the magazine. Ooh, and it is heavy. This magazine is very heavy. Okay, the inspiration for the October knit crate is the Patina of Time, faded peeling paint and rub down boards, pastel soft matte finishes, ceramic smoothness, and the play of shadow and light on everyday surfaces. These are the inspirations we've drawn upon for this month's knit crate shipments. Expect tile-inspired stitches and textures and beautifully crafted colorways from our designers and dyers. And it is called Verdigris. I'm not really sure. I'm not really sure how you pronounce that, but I'll put it up on the screen for you to see. And the patterns. The magazine, I have to say, is absolutely beautiful. It's got glossy, shiny paper. It's really thick. Like I said before, it's really heavy. So the crochet pattern is called Moss Balls by Brianne Malden. It looks like it is a beautiful cowl, and it is so pretty. The knit pattern, see if I can find it, is called Huerta by Pearl Knitter, and it looks like it is a shawl. It's very pretty. Ooh, it's a triangle shawl that's worked flat from the narrow point to one of the edges, and it's really lacy looking. It's very beautiful. And then also in the magazine, you get the other patterns for the other crates this month. And that's really fun and really cool. So if you have a project bag, you can just stick the magazine and your yarn in it and your crochet hook or your knit needles and you're good to go. So that's really awesome of Knit Crate. I love how they've come out with these magazines. And like I said, next month they are supposed to divide the magazine to where you don't get all the patterns. I think they're going to divide it to where one magazine will have the Knit Crate and the Sock Crate pattern. And the other magazine will have the Artisan Crate and the Sock Artisan Crate patterns. So I think that's a really fun idea. And again, they're only going to be splitting it up because of the weight issue. They don't want to go over their 1 pound mark. They love to put it in these beautiful boxes that the Sock Crate did come in this month. And they just want to keep that up. So that's really cool. There is a little sneak peek. It looks like the November theme is going to be Enchanted, which that sounds like a lot of fun. The mood board they have up is really pretty. It's got a lot of dark, dreamy, beautiful colors in it. And I'll show you that as well. Okay, so now let's open up the sock crate. Let me get this tape knocked off. There we go. Ooh, this was pretty. Look at this. It's got light blues and lighter blues and maybe some whites in there. It is so pretty and so soft. I love KnitCrate yarn. It's always so soft. It always smells good, and the colors are always beautiful, even if it's not a color that you might not love yourself, but you can make it for a friend or a family member or your mom or dad. Christmas is coming up, so these are really great yarns to crochet or knit presents with because they're going to be soft and luxurious, and your friends or family are going to really love these presents that you make them. So that's really nice. The KnitCrate yarn is absolutely gorgeous. It is called Vitalana Delight Light sock. The colorway is Morning. It is a 80% superwash merino wool and 20% nylon. It is a fingering weight yarn with 402 yards, 366 meters, and that's 100 grams. And all Vitalana yarns are made exclusively for KnitCrate as well. And the pattern. So I've got another magazine here, and it looks like the sock pattern. See if I can find that real quick. It is also inspired, the same inspiration. All the crates for that month are the same inspiration. So this would be the same inspiration as the KnitCrate. Ooh, the sock pattern is really pretty. It's got some zigzag cabling going on. It's called Twisted Argyle by Kate Atherley, and it is so pretty. I love that design. Very nice. And these are the two colorways that you could have gotten in this month's KnitCrate. Okay, so the KnitCrate membership is $19.95 a month, and that comes with one skein of yarn and a sock pattern, but now you also get it in a little magazine, so you get more than one pattern. The KnitCrate comes with two skeins of yarn, and that's $24.99 a month, and you also get a crochet pattern and a knit pattern, but now that they're doing the magazines, you get some other patterns as well, which is really fun, and it comes with a little magazine, so that's really nice. And so these were the colors for the October KnitCrate and KnitCrate. I had a lot of fun opening these with you. And don't forget to check out the other crates that KnitCrate has available as well. As a KnitCrate member, you can also earn stash points that you can spend on yarn or put towards earning free KnitCrates. The first step is to join the program. The second step is to start earning. For every $1 spent, you get one stash point. The third step is to redeem your stash points. There are other ways to earn stash points too. You can even get 100 stash points just for having a birthday. And I'm sorry my video is a little bit late this month, but I've been a little sick. I don't know if you can tell it in my voice, but I've been a little sick, so I've just had to put this video off till today. But I'll try to get this video out as soon as I can, and I hope you enjoyed it. I hope y'all are having a wonderful day. Until next time, bye!